welcome to a special edition of Mr. Z's weekly caption contest. First, congratulations to the person who submitted the winning caption for Peter Lastman's Jonah and the Whale, an actual picture of me running away from my responsibilities. Next, here are the three finalists for Victor Castillo's Born in 73. When everyone raises their hand and the teacher calls on you only. When no one in your team does work. Me feeling like I can do anything after passing the math test I didn't study for. This week's artwork is somewhat unique because I'd like you to summon your complete sense of sarcasm and wit for an artist who really deserves it, especially right now. It's by Utah-based contemporary artist John McNaughton, and it's called Crossing the Swamp. I show this image to you a day or two after loud and sometimes violent demonstrations have taken place in dozens of American cities in response to continuing exasperation at racism and injustices that keep surfacing from deep within the nation's systems of power. To say that John McNaughton is a laughingstock in the art world, that is, the part of the art world that is even so burdened by the background noise of amusing trivia as to be aware of him, would be a profound understatement. No dealer or gallery represents him because even the free marketplace recognizes that his products are toxic to business. McNaughton fancies himself a painter with something to say, not unlike Goya or Leutze. But the reality is that he is an amateurish editorial cartoonist who overworks his scribbles by covering them with oil paint. His practice is but one more frothy, inconsequential sphincter through which the American authoritarian white supremacist propaganda machine extrudes its excrement. Let us rejoice in captioning this work, and then let us inevitably forget it. To do so, click the link below. Thanks for watching.